right, so let's continue talking about Australian Aboriginal art. And we're going to talk first here about rock art. Go ahead and make a bullet and write down rock art. So make a bullet and write down rock art. Now, rock art is one of the longest continuously practiced artistic traditions in the world. This particular rock art or cave painting is from North Australia. So you can see in the painting here, the rock art, you can see how they use a lot of the white ochre. So you can see a lot of white. We can also see kind of some brown there as well, though that might have been black back in the day and just kind of faded quite a bit. But you can see a lot of white ochres. We can see a kangaroo, a lot of fish. Got even like a horseshoe crab right there. Or just regular crab. But yeah, you can see how they have a lot of different animals and such on here. Go ahead and make a one. And we're going to write down longest continuously practiced artistic tradition in the world. Write that down for number one. So one, longest continuously practiced artistic tradition in the world. Now we can see some other type of things they do as well with rock paintings. And this one, what you do, you take your hand and you put it against the cave wall, and then you take a red ochre or red clay color, and then you kind of splash it over your hand, and there you go, makes a little handprints. You can see their handprints here. And we see that rock art is still, you know, done even nowadays. Obviously, not really on rock anymore because this person is using a piece of canvas. But you can see how the painting and the designs, and you see how they're kind of similar to designs that they even do nowadays. Obviously, there's been some changes over time, as you can see. But you can see how it's still kind of done today. So still very similar, but also changes over time as well. New bullet, bark painting. New bullet, bark painting. Bark painting, very similar to rock paintings. So it's very similar to rock paintings in which the way how the animals and such are drawn is in a very similar pattern. So you can kind of see that right down here in our example on the bottom right. So we're gonna make a one and we're write down similar to rock paintings. So one, similar to rock paintings. And how you make the bark paintings is first what you gotta do, you gotta wait for it to rain. So you wait for it to rain. Then you go to a tree. So you see our tree here in the upper right. Go to a tree. Then you cut off a rectangular piece. Then you use stones and string to make that piece flat. Then after making it flat, you put it over some fire. Not close enough where it burns, obviously. Or warm coal, sorry. Warm coals, not over fire. Over some warm coals. That will flatten out the piece once it dries. Then, now it's nice and dried. Now you can do your painting on it. Gonna make a two. And we're going to write down, painted on bark for ceremonies, burials, and everyday objects. So two, painted on bark for ceremonies, burials, and everyday objects. Some everyday objects you might see design would be like a basket. So you can see these designs like on a basket made of wood. Dot paintings. Okay. All right, make a new bullet and we're gonna write down dot painting. So new bullet, dot painting. Now dot paintings, one, traditional dot paintings were made in sand. So bullet was dot paintings, and then one is traditional dot paintings were made in sand. So traditionally, your dot paintings were made in sand. You can kind of see here how it's being drawn in sand, that example. There are some other examples here as well, but you can see traditionally it was drawn in sand. And usually you use dot paintings were used to tell a story. Go ahead and make A2. Depicts a story using Aboriginal symbols. So depicts a story using Aboriginal symbols. So generally when you're doing it, you were using it as a medium to convey a story. So usually you're using it as a medium to convey a story. And then once you know the symbols, then you can understand the story. And as I said, it was kind of used as a visual way of telling a story. So you can see right here how there's a whole bunch of various symbols here. Like the if you see sidelines, usually that means rain. If it looks like kind of like a rainbow, it's a rainbow, so it kind of has this arch. A person, just a U-shape. So it's kind of like an overhead view of a person. Two people sitting. That right there, the little circular thing, can generally mean like a campsite, or it could be a well or a rock or so forth, or a fire, like campfire. Smoke or water or a fire could be wavy lines, as you kind of see there. Water holes connected by running water. Sitting down place, footprints. And the footprints you would make whatever animal you were trying to make, you would make them in kind of that style. Star, so a little bit different than our 5-point star we normally go with. They did a circle and then little circles around it. Boomerang, kind of curve shape there. Once again, wavy lines could be water, rainbow could be mistake. But it kind of just gives you kind of some of what those symbols would mean. And you can see kind of some other symbols here as well. We're going to make a 3. And we're going to use symbols to represent natural surroundings. So 3, use symbols to represent natural surroundings. I'll show you some other symbols here. So as I said, usually when you do tracks, you just do how the animal's tracks would look like. So kangaroo, emu, but sometimes you'll kind of draw the animal, like this iguana, it's a lizard. Footprints, you know, for a person, you know. Got some snakes there, frogs. So the frogs are like the black circles there. And then the warhol was in blue. Although obviously if you're doing this in a sand, you know, you would have your circles here in, you know, the sand, and then your other circles around, then you would say circles around there with the frogs. Men hunting, so you see how they're like a U-shape with a spear. Looks like that guy might have a boomerang with them. And women's ceremony. New bullet X-ray style. So X-ray style, as you can kind of see here, is that it depicts the internal organs and internal structure of an animal. So it depicts the internal organs or bone structure of an animal. So you can see a couple down here. You got like fish is the first one here. You got a wombat. You have a kangaroo. And then you have a sugar glider. So you can kind of see there how it depicts the internal structure of the animals. Kind of like, you know, if you did an X-ray. Go ahead and make a 1. And we're going to write down depicts internal organs and bone structure. So depict internal organs and bone structure. So an X-ray is pretty much what it means. It's an X-ray. Last one to talk about, make a new bullet body decoration. So new bullet body decoration. Now body decoration, how that's done is it's a very traditional practice. Usually you use it for ceremonies. So a traditional practice that you use for ceremonies. And we'll start off with that first and I'll explain more as we go. So make a one and we write down traditional practice for ceremonies or traditional practice for ceremonies. Now, with it being traditional practice of ceremonies, basically how it kind of works, you can kind of see how each one of these people have a different design on their bodies. When you're making these various designs, you take a pattern that's been passed down for your family like for years. So each one of these patterns has been passed down in that family for years. You're usually geometric in design, not always perfect. We can see how these guys' hands don't exactly match up there. Not always perfect, but they're supposed to be geometric in design. Go ahead and make a two. Write down geometric in design. When you're making these designs, it does include scarring. So you might purposely scar your body. Smear clay or ochres on face. You can see that in the picture. You might also wear ornaments or headdresses. We can see how this guy kind of has a little bit of feather sticking out there. And as I said, this has a pretty deep significance in terms of religion. So for religion, you're taking on a pattern that's been passed down your family for years, but that pattern is supposed to represent your ancestor. So we're gonna make a three. Use respected patterns of an ancestor. So this is supposed to be someone's, so this is like an ancestor's pattern. Remember we talked about in the dream time about how the world was formed by the ancestors. So these designs that they're taking on is a pattern of their ancestors that created the world. All right, let's go ahead and stop there.